RVLA students, Mr. Loud Ali, and today, or well, for the rest of the year, I'm going to bring to you guys a solid workout plan that you can do right in your living room with your brothers, sisters, aunties, uncles, parents, and you guys can stay in shape and stay fit and also do some of the things that I would do with you in my classroom. All right, so today we're going to go over what I call the GFE, ground force movement. I'm going to teach you guys how to move, get stronger, and have fun with your body in the ground. Okay, so number one, we're going to move our feet. Okay, so right here, we want to have our chest up, sit tall, all right, and we're moving our ankles and our feet. So we're going to go out, in, and we can do this about 5 times. You can do as many times as you want. We're going to do 5 for the video. All right, so we're going to go 1, out, in, 2, out, in, 3, out, in, 4, out, in, 5. Now we're going to do ankle circles. Go around in circles. You want to, the GFE is important because it helps you get your feet stronger all the way up to your neck. And also your hands and fingers, arms, every single part of your body. All right, now we're going to reverse. And you always want to stay calm. Don't sag your shoulders like this. Don't go like this. Sit tall because posture is everything. All right, so finish off the reverse circles. One more. All right, so now we're going to have 1 knee up. You want your other leg flat on the ground. And you want your foot behind the leg that's up. All right, just like this. We're going to sit tall. All right, we're going to put this leg up. And we're going to switch to the other side. And sit tall. So again, we're going to put this leg up and go the other way. Leg up, switch side. Okay, so now for those of you who can't really do that movement, all you got to do is go like this. Simple. All right, you don't have to worry about doing it right, but do the best you can. Okay? So now we're going to go up and over. Sit tall. Up and over. Sit tall. Up and over. Sit tall. All right, this stretches out your groin, loosens up your legs. We're going a couple more times. I know this is a weird movement. I thought the same thing when I was 17 doing this. All right, one more time. All right, now we're going to do the same thing, the same movement, but we're going to come up into a stance, okay? So what you want to do is put this leg up and over, follow it with the opposite leg, push yourself up with your back hand, come up into a stance. This is going to stretch out your groin. Come back down, same thing, leg up, both hands behind you to tap leverage, come up, stretch out the groin. Okay, these are all movements pertaining to the Washington State Standards for Physical Education. All right, so this will help mobility, body movement, and moving the body to get the body stronger. All right, if you cannot do this motion, just come up like this. All right, leg over, just come up just on one knee. Because a lot of people are stiff in their groin. All you gotta do is this. All right? Until you can get that motion down. We're gonna do a yoga pose. You wanna sit tall. All right? Don't sink your back like that. I don't wanna see this. Sit tall. Make sure your brother or sister is with you, or your mom or dad, get them to work out. All right? Spread your hands, your arms. You're gonna reach side to side. All right, this stretches out your shoulders. Try to reach your shoulder blade out to the opposite side. Try to sit tall. All right, run a couple more times. All right, good. All right, now, same position. But now we're going to try to touch the opposite side of our hand behind this. All right, so I'm going to show you. You're going to take this hand and take your opposite hand, reach behind you and try to touch your hand. Give yourself a handshake if you can. A lot of people are not as flexible. So like me on this side, I can't do this side that well because I'm a little tighter. So don't worry about that. Just relax, just do the best you can. Couple more times. Do not bend your neck like this. Try to stay sitting tall. All right, good. So to do it the right way, this is how you do it the right way and give yourself a handshake. Opposite hand, come here and touch your hands just like this.
Now we're gonna put both our knees up. We're gonna warm up our legs. And also, this can help get your legs stronger as well. I use it for a warm up, but all of this is what we're doing, kids out there. You can do this for a workout, and parents, and teachers. So, one leg up, switch. Point your toe towards you, switch. 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 Right when this leg comes down, you automatically switch to the other side. You're gonna feel a stretch in your hamstring. All right, and as you point your toe towards you more, you'll feel the stretch even more. This is your hamstring right here. All right, now we're gonna keep both legs up. Hold the opposite leg, drop the opposite leg to the ground. As soon as this leg comes up, you drop the other leg. This also stretches out your hamstring as well. You want to hold that knee tight. Take your time. Don't rush it. I can go a little faster. If you cannot get that leg down, it's okay to go like this. All right, you bend your knees. Just do the best you can. Okay, so we're going to go a couple more times. We're going to do elbows to knees, and I'll show you in a second. And I want you guys to remember when you guys are at home, this is to test how strong you are and to see how well you can move before we do the other things we're gonna do. All right, so we're gonna get on all fours and you're gonna go elbows to knee. 4 to 5, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we're gonna switch to the other side. Remember when your hands are on the ground, you want to take your shoulders and you want to squeeze down your lats to make everything tight and locked in. So you will have full control over your shoulder blade and won't get hurt. So we're going to do the opposite side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? If you cannot do this movement, full movement, it's okay. Do not force it though, because if you force your movement, then you're going to result into injury. You never want to force your movement. So do the best you can. So, for example, if I can't go to my knee, I'm just going to go like this. Just go as far as you can. We're going to do something we call crawling. Okay? Crawling, test your arm strength, get your fingers stronger, and also test your core strength. All right, so this might be very different, and it might look funny. You guys are like, what is Mr. Lanali doing? Why is he crawling on the floor? Oh, that's weird. He's too big to be doing that. You know, I get that a lot from some of these kids. All right, so, especially when I try to dance. So, we're going to crawl. And you guys can do this with your friends. Get your little sisters to do it with you. If you have a baby sister, she can crawl with you. We're going to crawl just like this. Put your palms up. Make sure your toes are tucked in. And crawl. This is the beginning phase. We're gonna move into a second phase. A little, I wanna say harder, but it's funner. It's more fun. Funner is not a word. All right. A couple more times. Good. Crawl like a panther, because we're the RVLA Panthers, right? Right now, we did the regular crawl. Now we're gonna get up on all fours, but still be in crawl position. This is really going to test how strong you are in your arms and in your core. All right. So we want, it's going to look like this. We went from here, level one, to here. You do not want to have your back like this. I don't want to see this. You want to make sure your back is straight. Try to. Okay. So you're in your living room. You're going to just crawl. Keep your core tight. And I'll show you a few tricks after this for those people who want to challenge themselves if this is too easy. It looks easy, but it can be tough. And go about 3 or 5 times. Back and forth. It's good. Good job. You guys are doing good. All right. Now we go side to side. Forward, backward. Try to keep up, you guys. Side to side. Forward, backward. Your legs will start to burn. Arms start to burn. Side to side. Forward, side to side. Make a square. Backward. Our second or third phase. This is for my guys and girls who want to challenge themselves. Mothers and fathers, uncles, aunties. You take the bottle, the water bottle. I'm pretty sure Miss Coleman would try to do this. She thinks she just can do everything. All right, take the bottle, place it on your lower back. You're gonna use your core, body stability, keep your shoulders tight, and you're gonna crawl with the bottle, all right? You can use a shoe as well, or a little small ball. Alright, you're gonna crawl. Keep your core tight. This is a core workout. I know we have my athletes do this, my pro players. Alright, side to side. And that's it. Alright, so make sure you guys are drinking your water. Remember, viruses out there. Stay hydrated when you guys are at home. Me, sometimes I like to challenge myself and I don't drink water at all until after. All right, but don't do that. All right, so now we're gonna do the same thing, but you're gonna be in push-up position. All right? All right, so we're in push-up position like this. Make sure the lats are tight, butt's tight, okay? All right, and we're gonna go side to side. So, hand here. Hand here, leg there, leg out, arm out, arm out, leg in. Leg out, arm out, arm out, leg in. All right, now we're gonna move. Tight core, tight butt, breathe. Push-up now. Let's do one more after this. Good. Now we're going to do our final movement, okay? So, remember the crab mission. Some of you guys have done a little crab race with me. PE class at the beginning of the year. All right, you're gonna be in crab position, okay? And you're gonna come up through your leg into push-up position. And you're gonna have a tight butt, tight core, look through the ceiling, look each way, stretch out your back, bring your legs back up, back into crab position. Make sure the whole goal of this is to stay low. For me, I'm a little taller, so it's a little more difficult. But some people can still stay low and being tall. Stretch your back out. Tight butt. Legs back up. One more time. We're almost done, guys. Now, walk
yourself up to your toes. You can stretch in.